and then you have to write something to wonder about what you saw, something new, ask a new question about what you saw, and then think what the answer could be for that. Okay, so first let us do this demonstration. Heading is again pressure only, relative pressure. Okay, this one the more specific heading is Pascal's Law. Right? Yeah, demo one, Pascal's Law.
So could you write the heading on the board?
Yeah, yeah, I'll write it. Pascal's Law. Pascal is the unit of pressure. Pascal is a physicist, so the unit of pressure is named after Pascal. Okay, now I have two syringes. This syringe has a smaller area of cross section, and this syringe has a bigger area of cross section. Is this clear what I mean by that? The contact area of the liquid inside the syringe will be bigger in this case. The contact area of the liquid inside the syringe will be smaller in this case. This much is clear to everybody? Yes? Okay. Now, both the liquids are closed from all sides by the walls of the container and the piston of the syringe on top of the liquid. So, this represents enclosed liquid. So, note down the concept. Enclosed liquid. That means there is no surface of the liquid which is free. The liquid is bound by some surface in contact from all sides.
So, but
doesn't
the tube
have a hole like this? Listen, I'll draw the diagram also. This is the liquid. This is a piston. And the liquid is filling it. And then they are connected by some tube. Okay? So liquid is there. So these two liquids are in contact, connected together, but the liquid is surrounded by a wall in all sides. That's what I meant by enclosed liquid. This piston is covering the surface, this piston is covering the surface. Here the liquid is surrounded by the walls. Understood? Enclosed. Now my question is, right now, imagine these two pistons have no weight, negligible weight. So the pressure everywhere in the liquid is, so pressure on the top of this liquid and on top of this liquid is equal or different?
Equal.
Now if I apply some extra force here, F extra, if I apply some extra force here, what will happen? This piston will go down. And what will happen to this piston? It will rise. So let us see whether it happens. I am pressing it. It's rising. Similarly, if I press here, it will rise here. Agreed? It makes sense? The reason is...
You have some more liquid.
Yeah, there is some liquid. You can see the yellow liquid.
You have more liquid.
No, whatever is there is already filling. So this liquid, what is the property? Incompressible. This liquid cannot be compressed. Its volume is fixed.
So it's not water?
No, it can be anything, water, oil, anything. So, but it should have a fixed volume. Liquids have fixed volume, right? Gases are compressible,
yes.
Not liquids. Agreed?
Yes.
The volume of a liquid is fixed.
Yes.
So if I move this down, this liquid has to move up. Agreed? Now how is this useful for us to do work? The use comes in the fact that if I apply say 1 Newton and if this area is very small, say 1 meter square, so what is the pressure here? 1 Pascal. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Now if this area is, I am just exaggerating, okay? If suppose this area is 100 meter square, okay? What Pascal's law says is, if there is an enclosed liquid, if I apply some extra pressure at any part of that enclosed liquid, that extra pressure will transfer undiminished to every part of that liquid. So if I apply extra pressure of 1 Pascal here, that 1 Pascal will be added to the pressure of, that 1 Pascal will be added to the existing pressure at every point in the liquid. That means even at this point, at the top of this liquid, that 1 Pascal pressure will be acting. So if I apply extra pressure of 1 Pascal, what will be the extra pressure which will arise here? 1 Pascal. So if the extra pressure is acting here, earlier there was no extra pressure. By adding one extra pressure of 1 Pascal here, one new extra pressure is arising here. So it will push the piston up. Okay. So what is that extra pressure? If I don't want it to move, I have to balance it by some extra pressure here also. So what pressure should I apply here so that it will balance this 1 Pascal? I have to apply 1 Pascal. Now you see what is going to happen. If I have to apply 1 Pascal here, and this area is 100 meter square, how much force should I apply here?
0.01 Pascal.
Great. Force is measured in units of Newton. Here I applied an extra force of 1 Newton. Think and then speak.
So because
pressure is
100 Newton.
Pressure is force by area. Area is 100 meter square. So to create that same extra 1 Pascal pressure here,
100.
How much force?
100
Newton I have to apply. Only then it will become 1 Newton per meter square. Only then it will become 1 Pascal. Do you get it? Yes.
So what if we apply infinite amount of strain on both ends?
You cannot apply infinite force here. How can you apply infinite force? That means...
Yes, you took the example of wheel having a lot of infinite strain and taking out. So
that is creating vacuum. It was not about strength, it was about creating vacuum. That means no air is present in the straw. So what you observed here, you see, imagine this piston, somebody can stand. If somebody with a mass of 1 kg, suppose somebody exerts a force of just 1 kg equivalent with his hand, pushes with a force equal to the weight of a 1 kg object, how much kg can it support?
100
kg. So by applying a force equivalent to the 1 kg weight, I can balance 100 kg weight. This principle is called as hydraulic jack. It is used to lift a car. One man can exert a force required to lift a car.
Also hydraulic bridges.
Yeah, hydraulic jack, hydraulic bridges, hydraulic brakes. This is the same concept. Now let us see it in action here. This is quite heavy. Each of this is 0.5 kg. So 0.5 kg, 1 kg, 1.5 kg, 2 kg. So this 2 kg, I need one assistant. Your job is to hold this with one hand so that it doesn't topple, one hand. And hold these weights with the other hand from the side so that they don't fall off. Don't hold it, just support it so that it doesn't topple. Yeah, you don't apply any force, just prevent it from falling off. Now if I press this, do you think I can exert a force of 2 kg weight with my thumb? See how thin I am.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I am actually pretty weak. Let me see if I can lift it. It's very easy actually. It doesn't feel like I am lifting 2 kg weight with my thumb. Now let me push it back. Okay, who is the weakest among you?
Sir.
Okay, he appears the weakest. Appearing.
Sir,
don't look weak for any of you. Okay, just try it. Okay, try with a little finger. Even with his little finger, he is able to lift 2 kg. Okay, who are Krishai? Come.
Sir, Krishai is very happy. So, I thought of
Krishai now already.
Yes.
So, does this mean...
Okay, try to lift 4 kg with your little finger. Yeah.
Come that move.
He is really weak. Hey, do like this. Hold the bottom with little finger, thumb with the, like this carefully, like this. Do. Yeah, it is. Okay, does everyone want to have a try or?
Yes, sir.
Okay, no. now lift it and see whether you can manage to lift it. Very heavy, right? Do you feel like you applied this much force to lift it? All right. You also lift it.
How can we worry if it is
no chance?
No chance, right? Okay, but if all of you come here, it will take a lot of time. So let us finish the second demonstration and. Okay, form a line quickly. Careful, don't top on the tripod. Form a line.
Watch the camera.
Watch the camera. Don't fall. Don't top it. Okay, come here. First, you and your finish. Wait, go back.
Wait.
Lift it first. So that you know how heavy it is. Okay, now place it on this. Okay, now. Press it. No. Yes.
You have.
It seemed to give you. No. No. Only between your fingers, no? Yeah, between your fingers. Yeah. It seems less, right? Okay, next.
Okay.
It's heavy. Now place it. Now press it between the two fingers. Hurry up. Seems very easy, right? Okay. Yeah. Hold it. Heavy? It's only a bit heavy. Okay, now lift it. Press, yeah. Press it between the two fingers. Yeah. Is it easy or difficult? Yeah. Next. Hurry up. We have to go to the second demonstration also.
Yes.
How much time left?
Tane. Shift off.
Okay, now press it between the two fingers. Seems easy, right? Next. Don't stop the video, okay? If at all, you can pause it, but do not stop it.
Yes.
If you stop it, it will become multiple clips. And then I have to combine it, it takes more time. Easy, right? Wait.
What would happen if we interchange the weight?
Okay, yeah. Now we'll lift it. It's very hard, right? Okay, who is left?
Sir.
Who is left? Sir. Yeah, do it. I'm holding this. Okay, now lift this. Lift it. Yeah. Hey, press the syringe. Yeah. So this is very difficult.
Right? So we'll be like lifting 10
kgs. Okay, now try to lift the other one. Now lift this. Now press this.
Tane.
Seems easier, right?
Tane.
Yeah. You haven't tried? Okay, hurry up. Wait. Yeah. Press it.
Easy.
Now try that.
Difficult?
What? Will it finish?
No, stop holding it. Stop holding it.
Okay, try this.
It's fine, yeah. It's not
like this.
I don't want anyone's face coming.
You need both hands. Okay, now let's go on to the next demonstration. Wait, we need to discuss the explanation.
So 10 minutes are left, so what will
you do? Yeah, we need to hurry up. Okay, try to lift it, hurry up. Easy? Now try this. Okay, now all of you write what you saw, what you think is happening. Hurry up, I will check your notebooks. Right, I saw that. Describe the setup, describe the demonstration. Please put today's date and write it. Give the heading Pascal's Law and write what you saw. You have paused it? Yeah, okay. Okay, now start it. Okay, now let me write the statement of Pascal's Law in meanwhile. So the statement will be part of your explanation of what is
what. But these are facts, right?
What? Yeah, principle of a hydraulic jack. So, excess pressure, please note down this definition also. Apply excess pressure applied at any point on an enclosed, I can hear lot of talking, I don't know why. Last row, are you writing the definition?
Yes sir.
Pascal's Law, how have you written it down?
Huh?
Okay, read what you wrote about Pascal's Law. I want you to read what you wrote, not tell from your mind. Read from your notebook.
Okay, sir. So basically, one Pascal is equal to 1 meter.
That is not Pascal's Law. That's wrong. I'm writing it right now. Can you please copy it? Excess pressure applied at any point on an incompressible liquid is transmitted undiminished Am I not using less energy to do more work? Good question. Answer is, of course we are not cheating the world, because whatever energy I use to do work, that much only is getting done when I inject this also. How? See here, carefully. If I press this by this much height, H1, and this area is A1, so the volume of water which went down is base area into height, so H1 A1. So V is H1 A1. So whatever volume of water went down, same volume of water will go up. Agreed? So this will go up by, let us say, this much distance. So this volume has to be equal.
So could it be shifted?
If, one second, now focus here. If this volume is being lifted up, but this area is a bigger area, A2, okay, then what will happen to the height by which this piston will go up?
So that will become lesser.
It will become small, so H2. So the height will be small. Here the height by which it moved is big, H1. So I applied my force over a bigger distance. Work done is force into distance, that is the definition of work. So I apply a small force over a large distance so that I do some work. And what happens? A large force, the weight is very large, it is moved by a very small distance. So that again the same work is only done. So if I apply the force by from here to here, 10 meters let us say, the car will move only 10 millimeters. So with one hand, if I apply a force for 10 meters, I will do a lot of work there. But the car, which is like very heavy, it will move only by say 1 millimeter or 2 millimeter or 1 centimeter. So the work done on lifting the car is same as what I do. It's the same case with simple machines. If I use a lever, I apply less force, but I move my hand over a large distance, the heavy load will be lifted up by a small distance. So work done is same.
Got it now?
Very good. Okay, Advai will read what you described for this demonstration. So the second demonstration we'll do next class. We don't have time either. Okay, Advai, describe what you wrote.
So what did you see? There's 20 minutes.
There is 20 minutes left. Two class is 35 minutes. So how much time left?
3 minutes.
Okay, then read. We'll do this next demonstration. We haven't written anything, means it's bad. Okay, read.
So, sir, we saw hydrogen gas within
N2. You saw hydrogen
gas? Sir, within N2.
That's it. Very poor discussion.
Sir,
yes,
sir. Sir, in the demonstration, I saw that when the weight is put on a larger surface area, it uses less pressure to lift it up.
Very wrong concept. Pressure is same on both the syringes. It requires, the pressure was same everywhere. How did you say that pressure is less? You are saying pressure is less here. If I give the weight here, you are saying pressure is less here. Force is less here. Listen.
Pressure is a force.
Force per area is pressure. Force is less, force is more. Area is less, area is more. See, listen. The same pressure you can get by big force acting on a big area or small force acting on a small area. Both will give the same thing. You can have 100 by 100 is equal to 1, or you can have 1 by 1 is equal to 1. Are you getting it? So if you want to apply less force to lift a bigger weight, apply that force on a smaller area and the weight should be placed on a bigger area.
So
yes.
Can I just check something with the scale, so on the left?
You want to check the distance travel?
Yes, sir.
Very good, come on. So let's check this. So yeah. Okay, start from here. Okay, wait, note down the initial position.
Sir,
okay, wait. Keep this at 0 now. So okay.
Sir,
keep it at 2. Okay, 2. Hold it. And we need one more scale. Okay, we'll keep it like this and we'll see how much it moves, okay?
Remove the 3.5 to 1.5 cm.
Okay, so this one moved up by 1.5 centimeters. Let us see how much that one moved. Okay, keep the scale on this. Keep it on this.
1 centimeter. This is 1 centimeter.
1 centimeter, okay, press it.